You may have heard of flowers being classified using the following pairs of terms: complete and incomplete, unisexual and bisexual, radially symmetrical and bilaterally symmetrical. But what do these words mean? In today's video, we will look at these important terms to understand one of the most fascinating structures of nature: flowers. Some flowers do not have all the four whorls of floral parts. That is, sepals, petals, androecium, and gynoecium. So they are called incomplete flowers. Conversely, the complete flower, which can be called as bisexual or hermaphrodite flowers, has both the stamens and the pistil. A unisexual flower has either stamens, like in the case of a male flower, or a pistil, in the case of a female flower. This unisexual flower divides into monoecious and dioecious. Monoecious is a plant which possesses both male and female, such as squash. However, dioecious forms if the male and female flowers are born on separate plants, such as papaya. Flowers which can be divided into two equal halves along more than one longitudinal plane, passing through the center of the flower, are regular or radially symmetrical flowers. An example of this includes the beautiful flower of hibiscus. Flowers which can only be halved along one longitudinal plane are described as bilaterally symmetrical, such as clitoria. All these characteristics show as the wonderful biological diversity of flowers. Pollination. Pollination is the transfer of pollen grains from the anther to the stigma. Self-pollination occurs if pollen grains transfer to the stigma of the same flower or a different flower in the same plant. Whereas, cross-pollination happens if pollen grains transfer to a flower in another plant of the same kind. Is cross-pollination better? In many ways, cross-pollination is better than self-pollination, as cross-pollination results in a more diverse gene pool. Continued inbreeding, or self-pollination, results in the production of offspring that are weaker and less adaptable to changes in the environment. In case of cross-pollination, offspring produced may have valuable qualities from both parents. This yields seeds that are better in quality and quantity. Due to more genetic variability in cross-pollination, more varieties of offspring can be produced. This increases the chance of survival of the species when facing changes from the environment, which is more likely to destroy all the varieties in a species. As cross-pollination is so important, plants have devised several mechanisms that enable them to restrict self-pollination. Dioecious is impossible to do self-pollination because it has separate male and female flowers. In many plants with bisexual flowers, the anthers and the stigmas may mature at different times. For example, custard apple. Plants with bisexual flowers may have their stigmas situated some distance away from the anthers, so that chances of self-pollination become less.